Alola, Pokemon Trainers, Professor Chaz here, the lab coat's on back order, and welcome back to our Pokemon Moon playthrough, episode number 78. As you just saw, we did a speed-up montage taking on the Elite Four here at the Pokemon League on top of Mount Lanakila, because in the last episode, what all did we do? It's been such a long time since I recorded, I can't remember what we did in the last episode. I know we did get things started for the next Ultra Beast and the final Ultra Beast encounter on Pony Island, but yeah, what I said basically, I want to get some more training for the team that I'm currently using, you'll see them in a moment, but I came here to the Pokemon League, and let me just say, I am quite happy with my decision to do a speed-up montage of the Elite Four Challenge, because that was over an hour of battling, and they made it so frustrating with their landing critical hits and landing attacks that shouldn't be landing, and, you know, I've complained about the Elite Four and things like Battle Tree before. I'm not going to waste time doing it again, but suffice it to say, the speed-up montage was a great idea. But we have dealt with all four of the Elite Four. We did take a couple more injuries on the team. I can't remember who all got knocked out, but the injury counter has been incremented by four. Took four injuries. I think, did Tapu Fini get injured? I believe it did. It did take one. Pandora took two, unfortunately. And Nebby took another knockout as well. So those are the four. Kind of hurts, but it is what it is. Anyway, the markings have been made. The counter has been incremented on the layout and all that good stuff. So the team is starting with Pandora, our level 63, Pangoro. She is a calm Pokemon with the Iron Fist ability, holding the Muscle Band to add more power to physical hits. She has Sky Uppercut, Bullet Punch, Crunch, and Parting Shot. Next is Tapu Fini at level 64, a hasty Pokemon, Misty Surge ability, holding the Mystic Water, powering up the Muddy Water and Hydro Pump, also has Nature's Madness and Aqua Ring. Next is Corgil at level 62. It still hurts me to look at all those injuries. Seven knockouts for poor Corgil. And part of that is because of Nanu in the last episode. We did fight him because he told us about the Ultra Beast on Pony Island. But anyway, Corgil here is a hasty Pokemon. Yeah, just like Tapu Fini. Anyway, Queenly Majesty is the ability holding the Phytinium Z, which we haven't made use of just yet. I guess I kind of forgot I had that. I don't think I really had a chance to use it in the battles, but we might use it against whoever's challenging us as champion. But she has Trop Kick, Low Sweep, Stomp, and Aromatherapy. Next is Nebby, our bold Lunala at level 63, with the ability Shadow Shield, holding the Leftovers, and the attacks are Moongeist Beam, Night Daze, Hypnosis, and Moonlight. Next is Dorothy at level 62, with the, she's a Drift Limb, of course, with the Unburdened ability, boosting speed when using the item, and the item is Citrus Berry. She has Hex, Gust, Will-O-Wisp, and Minimize. And last but not least is the Pokemon we kind of relied on for a lot of the tougher moments in the battles, Jiggy, the Gentle Jigglypuff. He is level 100. Feels kind of weird to say that our Jigglypuff was our Archie's ace in the hole, so to speak, using a TCG term, but he kind of was. He is level 100, and the Eviolite he's holding helps him out. Didn't make use of the competitive ability just yet, but it might come into play if a stack gets lowered. Competitive sharply boosts his special attack, and his only offensive move is Dazzling Gleam. He also has Thunder Wave, Light Screen, and Helping Hand, so he's more of a partner Pokemon for double battles. You know, maybe even a battle royal of switching things out and stuff, but I guess that could be true of anything, but Helping Hand is only going to help in a double battle. What am I trying to say? Anyway, that is the team as we see who is going to challenge us today. So, since this is kind of frustrating, like, you know, dealing with all of these Elite Four, and we're basically on par with our current team, 63s, 64s, like that. What I'm probably going to want to do from now on, I want to show off all the possible challengers to defend my title, but what I might decide to do is start designing teams, making use of some of the Mega Stones. Oh, that's what we did last episode. We defeated Trainer Red at the top of the Battle Tree, at least the easy difficulty of the singles. And we got four Mega Stones for three Pokemon. The Kanto starters, Charizardite, X and Y. We got Blastoiseite and Venusaurite. So what I might do is start making teams to defend my title, focusing on one Mega Evolution and bringing some other Pokemon that go along with that. So we might start doing that as a bit of a, maybe each episode. I might even ignore the Elite Four thing, because I'll probably bring all level 100s as it is. But yeah, I might start doing that just to start off each episode. But let's take our throne. We are the champion of Alola. Who's going to try to mess us up now? Why are you here, Fava? I thought he might be one of the challengers.
Champion? Now that is a title that everyone in Alola would bow before. I'm already a champion when it comes to power and prestige, after all. Taking this title would be my just desserts.
I get up immediately. Let's go, buddy. Now, interesting thing, I was talking to my nephew about this. It seems like all your challengers only have 5 Pokemon. Right, see? 5 Pokemon. So, it's kind of a letdown because you would think the champion should have, or not the champion, I'm the champion and I have 6, but you would think that your final opponent should have a team of 6, right? Now, the thing is, remember, these guys, or girls, whoever challenges you, have to go through the Elite Four as well. And, you know, maybe there's a chance, what if they ran out of revives along the way? So they've revived Pokemon against the Elite Four, but they only have 5 Pokemon because one of them is knocked out and they have no more revives. Also, apparently they don't use anything like full restores in the battle, so that might be another thing too. They've run out of healing items to get to this point. So that kind of makes sort of sense, I guess, when you think about it that way. Oh, we fell asleep. Wake up! Darn. Alakazam! Now, are we going to get to see Mega Evolutions? This thing can have Dazzling Gleam. Huh. What is our best way to deal here? I guess Nebby? What do you think? I could have Energy Ball, Dazzling Gleam, of course, Psychic Attacks. Electric moves like Charge Beam, I think. All that being said, Nebby's probably our best. Yeah, just in case it has Dazzling Gleam. I was considering just going for a full heal or an Awakening or even a Chesto Berry, waking up Pandora, but I'm expecting Dazzling Gleam. Here it is. I know my Pokemon. I fought Alakazam many a time before. And we can go for the Night Daze for super effective, but this is Lunala we're talking about. Let's go with the signature attack of Moongeist Beam. As you Dazzling Gleam. Going for the rhyming scheme, are we? Alright, and scheme rhymes too. I didn't plan that. That just kind of, now I'm trying to think of a rhyme for that. And I'm failing. But what I'm not failing at is putting Faba in his place. This guy's going down. Challenging me, champion of Alola, after you've already claimed Dorothy with your Bruxish? I remember this thing. Now, what Pokemon is going to be your Z attack user? Do you even have a Z attack? Do you have the Z ring? I don't know. I guess we'll find out eventually, though. I would expect your Alakazam to be... No, Hypno. You've got a Hypno. I remember that. I'm hip to your ways. At least we're getting some training, though. Now, if the final Ultra Beast is level 65, as I fear. Oh, by the way, it is currently about 4:30 a.m. in the Alola region. I forgot to mention that. But if we do encounter the Ultra Beast and it is more than level 65, I guess it's kind of okay. Like, we're almost level 65 as it is. The last time we took on an Ultra Beast level 65 was UB04 Blaster or Celestula. And look at this. I'm not even paying attention. We're just cleaving. Cleaving? Yeah. Like a cleaver. That's it. We're cleaving through this guy's team. Faba, you're a has-been. Get it? Like, Faba-been, Faba-been, has-been, whatever. Hypno! But, if it is gonna be level 65, the final Ultra Beast, we're kind of on par. However, I have a feeling it's gonna be level 70. I don't know why. I thought the last one was gonna be level 70 based on the pattern we were seeing with Ultra Beast levels, but apparently that was not the case. Nice job, Nebby! Faba is done for. We are still the champion. Did you ever doubt it? I don't think you did. Not when I'm going to use a legendary Pokemon, of course. Usually I don't do that, but it's Nebby, you know? Nebby was part of the main plot playthrough story of the game. This child has done it. This child has done it. And, oh yeah, you're sleeping. Wake up, Pandora. If you hadn't fallen asleep, you could have single-fistedly, with Iron Fist, taking down everything Faba had to offer. You're back, you're awake, you are good to roll. Does Nebby need to be brushed off? No, actually, I find whenever... Is it Moongeist Beam that does it? I don't know. A lot of times, Nebby seems to get all dusty. Usually that's Dorothy's job with the Gust Attack, but... Anyhow, Faba... Go away. I admit you have potential. You have proved to me that my judgment of you when we first met was flawless, as usual. You are a worthy champion. Get back to the Aether Foundation, buddy. Oh yeah, I forgot. We get to see a nice little cutscene-y thing here. But we don't get to see like a Hall of Fame thing. That's a tiny little bit let down. But anyway, so Pandora, Tapu Fini is now a champion as well. Cordial, We see Nebby is next up. Actually, Nebby and Dorothy haven't gone through the Elite Four yet, but now they have, and they have the ribbon for completion. And Jiggy has it, too! Of all Pokemon from previous generations, it's kind of funny Jiggy's one of the ones to get it, but soon everybody's going to have it. One of my favorite things, I said many times, collecting ribbons in every Pokemon game. Definitely, all of my main Pokemon from all games are going to have the Alolan Champion ribbon, as well as, if possible, the Battle Tree ribbon, which we did earn when we took on Trainer Red and defeated him with Zapdos, Irwin the Crocodile, and Sonata the Primarina. Alright, the team is right there. So we've defended the title. Now, where do we go again? Just right out here. Alright, let me just... I want to show off the ribbon. You know, let's look at Jiggy, because he has so many ribbons as it is. Actually, wait. Let me go here to Pandora. You see, a single ribbon. I showed Zapdos' ribbons off last time. Look at all these ribbons. I love it. I'm a collector, you know? I'm kind of like that Lawrence the Third guy from Pokemon 2000. Was it Pokemon the Movie 2000? I think it was. I think that's the actual title. Alright. Now, I don't know exactly how long this episode will be due to all the speed up of the Elite Four. I think based on the time... Hang on. So he tells me who was in my party. The first Hall of Fame entry, latest title defense. It doesn't show me pictures of. This is kind of what I wanted to see, you know? He just tells you the text. I wonder if they did that to, like, save data in the game. Because there's a lot of data in this game. Or I should say these games, Sun and Moon. But remember back when you would have the Hall of Fame on the PC and... I've taken a picture before. Let's do it again, see if anything different shows up. That's something IceKing688 left on one of the comments, letting me know, or left in one of the comments, letting me know that, Do I see anything? Oh, hi. What's up? Anyway, saying that there's a few different photo spots that I haven't done yet. Zoom it out a little bit, face this way. No, that's the other way. This is just wasting time for us, lass. Look around. Why are you going all the way back there? No! Okay. Really? What? Why would you just disappear? You didn't get stuck back there, did you? I think you did. Now, why does this look different? Mm-hmm. Rotom agrees. I think it actually got stuck behind that ice. Come on. What are the chances of that happening? You know what? Let's show the photos that we have. Yeah, we have to move on, Rotom. You guys see that? That is our best... No, that's our best one there. We're going to show this one off. All right. That's the best we've got. Give me the thumbs up. Give me the comments. Is that how you take photos? It is. Quite splendidly. Thank you for agreeing. I like this kind of angle. I live close to that spot. You live on an icy mountain? I feel sorry for you. You're up late, working hard. Falling snow looks so romantic. I like the atmosphere.
You might have photographed me.
I don't think so. Wow, that's actually really good thumbs ups. 9,200. I'm almost at 100,000. So, I might, like, okay, leave a comment. Do you guys want to see me go to all the different photo spots? Because I can do that and try to get as many different photos as I can. I could also at one point go back through the SD card and show you all the different photos that I've taken thus far. The ones I remember to save, at least. So I was going to say something else, but I lost track of that, so let's ignore that. I think I was talking about how the Hall of Fame shows you the Pokemon in your party when you completed the Elite Four each time, but I completely lost track of that. So, what is next in our mission, I guess... Do I change my battle style now? I think I do. I've done the Smug style for quite a little bit. So, there's a few things... Again, leave comments on this also. Do you want to see me do all the title defenses? Because there's a number of trainers that I can fight. Robert Gosney has previously told me that there are 10 different people that you can battle. And I've done two of them, or technically three. Kukui, Hau, and Faba. I have a suspicion Gladion is going to be one of them. Because he says something at the Aether Paradise about, you know, I can't... Or something like testing his might against the Elite Four or something like that. So I expect he's going to be a challenger, but I'm kind of curious to see who all else is there to challenge my title as champion. And I like the idea of randomly selecting Pokemon from my collection. I use like a random number generator and choose Pokemon. I'll probably choose specifically a Mega Evolution, and then choose 5 random ones from the rest of the team, ones that we haven't used yet maybe, and go from there. And I can show off all the different champion challenges if you guys want to see that. But you also want to see all of the battle legends that we might be able to make it to and take on in the battle tree, because I'm going through there. I'm going to get as many battle points as I can to get all the competitive items for Wi-Fi battles, as well as the Mega Stones too. So let me know if you want to see all of these, basically, cream of the crop, top of the class battles against the challengers of the Championship League and the battle tree. All right, let's change battle styles. Is there anything else I can go for? Left-handed style. I think I've done this, but let's just switch it up again here. The smug style was pretty cool, kind of throwing the ball across myself there. And now you can call me Link, because I am now left-handed. Did you guys out there know, guys or girls, I shouldn't specify, I suppose, but do you folks, as I try to say, out there know that Link, the hero of the Legend of Zelda series, is left-handed? Now, if you played nothing but the Wii version of Twilight Princess, you might be confused about that, because, of course, he was right-handed in that, but it was more to do with the Wii remote, and they had, I didn't realize this, but they completely mirrored the map from the, was it GameCube? Was it a GameCube and a Wii title? I think it was, wasn't it? I'm kind of sidetracked here, but I liked how I was watching somebody play the GameCube version of Twilight Princess, and they had to go to the Gerudo Desert, and they start moving the cursor on the map to the left, and I was like, you're wasting your time, that's somewhere else, the desert's to the right. And then they clicked on the thing, and they flew to the desert, or they teleported to the desert, and I was like, how'd that happen? And then, oh right, it's reversed, I played the Wii version. Anyway, what are we do here? So we're going to head to... Well, what I want to do... I don't know, do I want to go after the Ultra Beast right now? See, I had a thought. My thought is, let's just quickly head over here to... Is it Ula Ula here? Yeah, we're going to head over here. Because they said, like Nanu told us, that he had lured UB05 Glutton to the deepest part of Resolution Cave. And we've already been in there, and I pointed out Resolution Cave is quite similar to a previous area that we have adventured into. Well, not here on the channel, but I've adventured. I'm sure you folks out there have as well. It's basically where you find Zygarde, and it's the complete exact layout in Resolution Cave. So I was tempted to get Zygarde to help us deal with Glutton. Do you guys want to see me do that? I don't know if I really want to use the legendary, because I've already got Tapu Fini, and that's going to be our legendary to use against it. But, I don't know, I kind of like the idea of using Zygarde in the Zygarde room, so to speak, to deal with the Ultra Beast that's conquering that area. I'm going to hold off for now. I don't want to encounter the Ultra Beast just yet. I want to get your feedback on that. Do you want to see me use Zygarde against the Ultra Beast? Because I could use Tapu Fini and Zygarde as a combo. Now, what I'm going to do instead, one of the other battle styles that we can do, we have to... stand above all others in the Battle Royal. And here's what I want to do with this. I've heard some things about a certain aspect of the game that I haven't had a chance to experience myself just yet, but we're going to in a little bit here. Basically, I've heard Mega Evolution is, in a way, kind of bad. And I'm not sure exactly why. I remember, I think it was one of Jay Witz's posts on Twitter for one of his own videos, or maybe it was actually the description of the video, saying how every time we Mega Evolve Pokemon, we're doing a terrible thing. And I'm like, what are you talking about? I mean, okay, I know Glalie's jaw breaks open and can't close anymore, but it reverts back, right? That's not the worst thing. But I think there's something about Pokedex entries that imply some kind of negativity as far as... Mega Evolution goes. So what I want to do, I'm going to go into a Battle Royal, and where is my battle teams? Okay, we got Blaze here. I have him holding Charizardite Y, because he's more in tune with being a Mega Charizard Y, but what we're going to do is switch his item to Mega Charizardite, or sorry, Charizardite X, because I want to see a Mega Evolution, just to read what the description says. Like, okay, I want to make him Mega Evolve, because I want to show the first Mega Evolution on camera. Now, I can do the other Mega Evolutions off camera and just, you know, read what the Pokedex says there. I'll probably show you guys on camera what the Pokedex says if you guys want to see that. But I kind of want to wait and use all the Mega Evolutions when we take on the Elite Four challenge again. Where is my... This is Charizard 8Y. Where's Charizard 8X? We want that item. There's a bunch of X items right there, but those aren't the ones we're looking for. But essentially, I do want to just see a Mega Evolution on camera. Who else should I use? I'll just leave Team 1 as is. We'll go into a Battle Royal and see if we can stand above all others and get that last, or not the last, but one of the next battle styles that we can get. Battle Royal Reception Desk. Let's have a Battle Royal. What rank will you enter as? Okay. I hope I can choose my team from the PC. Now, I'm also going to point out, you might hear something in my tone of voice right now. I am kind of sick. Last night, when I was heading home... Oh, good, I can use the team. Last night when I was heading home, and I was doing a little bit of Pokemon going around. Now, first of all, yesterday was a massive day in Pokemon Go. I took down a level 6 Team Valor gym all by myself. Kind of like doing my hit-and-run tactic of focusing, getting that first Pokemon taken down. Or actually, I'm going for two at a time because you can take down 1,000 points of prestige every time you beat a Pokemon in a gym. So, I was going for two at a time, healing up between minimal revive use, but I had to use a lot of potions, but I got plenty of those. And I managed to take the gym down after a while, but maybe I was out in the cold a little too long, because I've got sniffles, my throat is sore now, I've got plenty of cough medicine and cough drops, and I got chicken soup and orange juice, so I'm going to try to take care of myself. But if you can hear my tone of voice, I sound kind of sick a little bit, that's the reason. So, let's go ahead and lead... I want to see Mega Evolution immediately. We're going to lead Blaze, we'll bring Zapdos and Irwin, because we've got choice items on those too, and widespread moves as well. Now, do we get to stand above all others in the Battle Royal? Because if so, we can try out that other battle style. But this time, I want to keep an eye on what my style looks like. This is just going to be a basic left-handed throw. Oh, wait, put me in the Charizard corner. Come on, do it. Is this different music? No, I think it's the same. Okay. What corner am I in? Come on. Oh, I'm in the Tyranitar corner. Okay, let's do this, Blaze. Now, he's not really equipped for physical attacks. He has Solar Beam to deal with that thing. However, he does have Incinerate, at least, which hits everything. And Armaldo, so we're not going to get super effective on anybody here. What is that other one there? I didn't even pay attention. Rhyperior, Armaldo... I can't see. Xplat, there we go. I just want to basically, if I lose this, that's fine, but Mega Evolution. And let's go with... Rock is definitely the biggest threat. Who's going to hit me with a rock attack? I'm going to say... Well, Rhyperior is probably going to rock slide. But then we're also weak to ground. So let's go for the Mud Slap on Rhyperior. All right. First Mega Evolution here, folks. Mega Blaze X is on the field. Again, his better way is Mega Charizard Y because of the Drought as well as Solar Beam, which is kind of cool. Essentially, oh, there's the Rock Slide. I can use Blaze as Mega Charizard X or Y, but... Or no, I'm trying to think. I can use him as Mega Charizard Y. Why? Why are you picking on me? Why would you do that? Anyway, I can use Blaze as Mega Charizard Y for the Drought to make Solar Beam hit immediately, or I could also go with the Grassinium Z to turn Solar Beam into Bloom Doom. I have some pretty good power behind that. Alright, so we are Choice Scarf, which means we're going to lock ourselves into a move. We're going to go with the... Probably our best thing is going to be Earthquake. Can we get a knockout and get the Moxie boost? Come on, take this Rhyperior down. It probably has, what is it? What is that ability called where it takes less damage from super effective hits? I can't recall. Okay, we resist that, fortunately. Rhyperior has to recharge. Ooh, Giga Impact into the rock type. That's an intelligent exploit right there, folks. So how are we doing on the points? We don't have any wins yet. Aggron, double weak to ground. I kind of like that. Now, can we get a Moxie Boost knockout? Come on. We are choiced. Not choice banded. Our choice scarf. Can we get the Moxie Boost with a knockout? Setting us up for another couple of knockouts. There's Exploud down. All right. As long as we can survive this turn, we can probably take the other two down, plus whatever else this was. Jaden, I think. Oh, they both went after the wrong thing. Sweet. Aw, I can't touch that. I can switch to Zapdos at some point, though. But let's go with the Earthquake again. We're going to outspeed everything. Taking down, the Aggron for sure, or Maldo maybe. Watch that Armaldo HP drop. Yes! Attack sharply boosting. So we got 3 points now. We still have 2 Pokemon remaining, so that's basically 5 points on our side. And did anyone lose all their Pokemon yet? Power Herb? Oh, it's coming after me? Really? Why would you pick me? Alright then. We're at +3 attack, but whatever. So, what comes in next? So, basically, I've got 4 points sorted up. 3 knockouts, 1 Pokemon remaining. Togekiss comes in. That looked shiny for a second, I thought. Another Armaldo? What? It's gonna Rock Slide everybody. I gotta go for some quick points. Let's go for the Unpheasant with Thunderbolt. Look at the slowdown, everybody. Now, this has to be a knockout. We're Choice Specs. Thank you! Now, this Armaldo could go for the Rock Slide. Rock Polish. Alright. Use Water Pulse, Togekiss. Hit this thing. Why? You guys see that? What was the point of that? Alright, so we're locked into the Thunderbolt. Buffalant is still in first place, or the Buffalant Trainer is. Let's just go for some damage on... Okay, let me do the math here. The most... No, okay, so I've got 4 points. If I go after the Togekiss, well, they're at only 2 points. Is there anyone in danger of beating me, basically, is what I'm trying to figure out. Buffalant can learn Head Smash, so it could take out the Togekiss. Well, okay, I'm the fastest on the field. I don't think we'll knock out Togekiss with a Thunderbolt, but we'll do our best. Ooh, Extreme Speed! Leave me alone! With a critical, even. This is just a madhouse of... Well, it's free-for-all, of course. Alright, I was going to show us what I know, but that was a critical. So we're at 5 knockouts. 1 Pokemon remaining. And that was their last one, wasn't it? Togekiss? No, they got one left, I think. Maybe. There's a lot to keep track of. Escavalier. Alright. So the Buffalant is probably still our biggest problem. Look how... This is the best I've ever done in a battle royal. Like, I've done online battles. Quick Claw, why? But I've done online battles before. Stop hit... Well, okay. I was going to say, stop hitting me, but it makes sense because... why are you faster? Rock Polish. But it makes sense you're going after me. But I've got 5 points. Does it matter that I'm the first one out is the question. You know what I didn't do? I didn't pay attention to my throwing style. Why? I've got 5 points. I thought that's what mattered. I don't understand the scoring for Battle Royals. I thought all that mattered was that you get the points. So, I guess being knocked out of a Battle Royal means you're out of the running for winning. I know that now, at least. You know what? No. I can do this again at some point. Do you guys want to see this on camera? Just let me know that is in the comments as well down below. But we gave it our best. Oh, wait. We can get battle points here, too. I didn't know that. So let me just open up the old Pokédex. See what it says about Mega Charizard. Wait. We don't even have Charizard in the Pokédex, do we? Huh. Now, how do we do the National Dex? I mean, I know... Well, I think you used Pokémon Bank for that. Let me just try this. No, it's not going to show me Charizard. Well, I guess what I'll have to wait and do is Mega Evolve something that is in the Alolan Pokédex. Before we can find out what's going on there with the sort of sinister, not super happy Pokédex entries as far as Mega Evolution goes. Let me think. I'll have to get Mega Stones from the Battle Tree. Which I can do again, I can get points off camera and then show that on camera. So, I think as far as Mega Evolution goes, I will hold off and reserve that for when we take on the, or when we defend our title at the championship, or the championship title at the Pokemon League is what I'm trying to say. And I'll show you the Mega Evolution each time we take on a different challenger. So the first one that we do, I guess, will be Blaze. Mega Evolution for Mega Charizard Y. For the remainder of this episode, is there any other last things? Well, hang on. Is it considered daytime yet? Probably not. I think it was IceKing688 or Robert Gosley. Both of you have been very helpful with your advice on what I can do during the playthrough here for the post-game. One of you said, in the Mali Garden, on the northwest bench during the day, there should be somebody that can talk to about the shape of the pond. So, I'm gonna go do that. And just see if there's anything there. I might just be wasting time. It might be not quite the right time of day. I also, since I have Nebby in the team, I want to go check out that ultra wormhole. Or I guess the, what would you call it? Just like that weird crack in space that is at the altar of the moon. Now, I don't remember if that's supposed to be... Where am I going? Supposed to be a daytime or nighttime event, but I'll go check it out just to see if it's available right now. And if so... Well, I don't know if I have time to really check it out, but... Northwest. Wrong way. Going this way. But I'll see if I can find out if there's anything I can do with that portal, and if not, then I can come back at the other time of the day. And was there something else that was day-specific? Just one sec. Okay. I thought I heard a weird sound, like a reverberating woo, 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 but I don't know if it was in the game or not. Turns out it's just something outside, so that is fine. What in the world is the secret of the pond in this garden? So she must be who I talked to. Yeah, they said something about the shape of it. Oh! I can see the shape of it already. That's Zygarde. Isn't it? I think. Huh. I think that's a Zygarde. The shape of this pond here. Anyway, so there's nothing we can do just yet, but we'll come back. I'm going to record the next episode later tonight, and it will be around midnight, therefore being a noontime episode in-game. So, one more thing that did come to mind, I wanted to check this out. Here in Po-Town, it says there's a shady house. I don't know if that's referring to the mansion that Team Skull basically commandeered and took over, or if there's some sort of other house in here that has some secret to it. So, I'm gonna waste even more time, perhaps, checking this whole town out, because did I really give it a thorough search last time I was here? I'm not sure if I did or not. But we are going to find out. And I like this music. So Team Skull still hangs out here, though. The graffiti is still prominent. You're in Team Skull territory now. Whoop. The graffiti covers a sign so you can't read anything else beneath it. Alright. Do I still have to pay money for the Pokemon? Oh, wait a minute. How did I miss this? I can't even grab it. Where is that? There it is. Max Repel. Oh, by the way, I have to restock a lot of my items because I went through so many potions taking on the Elite Four. We're gonna get strong enough for anything, even if we don't have that old barricade. Later days, Team Skull. Farewell, my misspent youth. You poor fellas, you have nothing left to do with your lives. Go to, Icky Town. How is training you guys up to be, like, good, upstanding members of society? Is this the Shady House? Can't even get in, so apparently not. Now, the Pokemon Center. I'm just curious. Are they still gonna charge me? Because I'm, like, your buddy now, right? Ready for rhymes in your ear, yo. Yo, what are you doing here, yo? This is what's left of our Team Skull hideout. Gotta get paid, then we gotta ride out. Team Skull leftovers represent. We may have lost heart, but we will never relent. I feel like we fell right in the abyss. So, why'd you come to a place like this? The clothes you're wearing are so unbearable. To tell you the truth, I find it quite hysterical. You leave Purple alone. Hey, yo, check spin to spin it. Spin.
Looks like you got no sense of fashion, yo. Don't you know that's our passion, yo?
I'll show you what we got with... I'll show you what we got to help you decide. We got tops more fly than Charizard Glide. Oh, I can buy stuff here? We got the roughest tank tops that you've ever seen. And when you wear a skull tank, you're sure to look mean.
Spin.
With the price so low, you can't say no. It's just 10,000. You want to buy one, yo?
Yeah, I'll take it. I'm rich. I can afford this. They're probably like, what? Really? I bought a skull tank.
Making mad sales to get out of this scrape. Gonna get that money to make our escape.
Spin to spin, 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 spin to spin, spin to.
Oh, they're gone now. Alright. Oh, there's no one to buy items from. Of course, I knew that. Why are you still passed out?
That's enough, Grunt. Back into your ball.
And it doesn't even say spin, it's just a zzzz. Is that a Rayman Raving Rabbit on the menu up top there? Or is that supposed to be a Mimikyu? Wait a minute. There's one more thing I realized I forgot to do. It just came to me when I saw the what looked like Mimikyu. There was one other person that I think IceKing688 told me to go talk to. It's in Mali City. I think it's the main Pokemon Center on Mali Island. I'm just going to make sure I haven't missed anything in a potential shady house here. And if not, I guess I'll round out the episode talking to a Mimikyu or its trainer. I can't remember which one it's supposed to be. But, oh, I can't even... I gotta go through the little path thingy. Alright, then. We're twins, so we're always being compared. So I'm sure you want my... You get my one to be just as good as her. I already fought. Okay. We fought her, and they're saying the same thing. Good enough. Can't even go in here. No? I guess the only shady house is gonna be the mansion, which... You'd think they would've called it something different than... Shady House. Right? I don't know. Maybe I'm just being weird. Moves like Horn Drill and Guillotine never hit, whatever. This doesn't even have a door. That's an interesting place to live. Yeah, so none of the houses you can go in. You'd think that they would have had, you know, at least something, but... I forgot we can go over this way. Okay. Now, I guess it's a... Ooh. How many Zygarde cells is this? How close are we to assembling the perfect form Zygarde? Because if I can form the perfect form Zygarde, I might as well bring it for the UB05 encounter. I need 11 more. Maybe what I'll do... Yeah, maybe what I'll do in the next episode, a bit of a speed-up montage. Like, I'm the kind of person that doesn't want to look up the information where to find the cells, but I might have to do that. But I guess I can start the next episode with a region-wide Zygarde cell hunt. Might actually be kind of cool to do. So I think this is everything here in Po Town. Since I'm here, though, I'm going to check out that big mansion, I guess, which is the Shady House, one last time. See if there's anything I'm missing in here. Maybe there's another hidden Zygarde cell somewhere. There's a Team Skull Grunt. The boss is a complete bully, but I'm an incomplete grunt. Sometimes I want to smash world, but I'm always afraid of it. Whatever. All right. Look, another Rayman Raving Rabbit. Oh, I can't sleep in the bed? Good. Kind of didn't want to. This place looks grungy as all get out. Guzma. Couldn't become a captain. Still. Now let's take us to the backyard, where we got an ice stone at one point to evolve our Alolan Sandshrew if we wanted to, but of course we don't, because Alolan Sandshrew is too adorable as it is. And is there anything else? I doubt there'd be a cell in one of the rooms, but you never know. I'm not going to talk to these folks. I think they're all saying the same thing as it is. You'd think after getting the main story complete, they would say something different, at least some of them. The Team School password is beat up. Does it mean the password itself is to say the word beat up, or did the password get beat up by a Team Skull member? That's the question. The answer is pretty simple, because why would it be beat up? Alright, here into... Oh yeah, this back area. Bear with me as I re-explore everything that I've already explored once again, and finding nothing new of consequence. Wait, anything in here? Nope. There's never anything in the garbage cans anymore. You ever notice that? I remember back in the SS Anne in Pokemon Red and Blue, you can find a Great Ball just sitting in the kitchen garbage can. Like, of all places, why there? But, you know, free Great Ball, I'll take it. Won't use it, but I'll take it. It's cash. Cash in the pocket. Have I seen this? There are slightly faded Pokemon dolls sitting on top of the bed. Lapras and Skitty. The shelves are filled with makeup items such as mascara and eyeliner. Is this... Would this be, Plumeria's room? Huh. It seems very nice and clean and pristine and stuff, so... I don't know. Anyway, moving on. Plumeria is still outside. Does anyone know why she's out there at the Hina Desert Oasis? In the camper? Or the trailer? Like, why there? Team Skull is still here in the shady house. You'd think they'd all still be hanging out. Look at this mess. Are these all Wii U? Yeah, they're... Look! This is their games room. Okay, I never noticed this the first time coming in. There's another note there. We already know the passwords. We don't need that. Look, bottles everywhere. Come on, guys. Clean up. Clean up after yourselves. If you want to have a path or an audience with Master Guzma, follow the path. Yeah, we haven't seen Guzma since... Oh, I can't go this way. Since Paula took him to become a more respectable trainer. I wonder if he's here, or if we won't get to see him. Like, I guess, I haven't thought about this, but maybe Guzma will be one of the challengers of the Pokemon League, too. That could be a thing. Yep, Guzma's not here. Can I grab another Beginium Z? Nah, alright then. And let's just see if this works again. I'm gonna grab a seat. The arms of the chair look like they've been slammed countless times by angry fists. Now, we don't get to see the cutscene again where the Team Skull dude comes flying in. Why does Guzma have a triple pillow bed? That's a huge bed. Alright, so I guess that is it. We're just going to pop on out here in the broken glass window. I guess I'm going to head right back to where it all began. Let's go talk to my mother. We haven't seen her in forever. We'll just catch up with her, get healed up, and then I'm going to do a run around the entire region everywhere I can think to go, trying to look for Zygarde cells. There's only 11 left to go. If need be, I'll look them up. And no, wait. Again, I'm getting sidetracked. I'm going to Mali City. I'm going to go talk to the Mimikyu trainer. And then I'm going to go see if that Ultra Wormhole is going to kick into gear. That's how we're ending the episode. Then, the next episode, I might begin my... Well, I'm going to begin my search for all the Zygarde cells that I might have missed out on. So, is this where the Mimikyu resides? Do you think Mimi cleans her clothes? Wait, I've done this. Oh, okay. I guess I did remember to do that. I got the Reaper Cloth. That's what happened there. Man, I'm much smarter than I thought I was. Sometimes. Alright, let's head off to Pony Island and just see. Is it... What is this? Technically 5 a.m. Alola time. Is this the time of day that we can access this portal wormhole, or do we have to wait till noontime? Let's go. Normally, I like to be nice and ominous and walk slowly up the stairs, but we don't have time for that. In fact, you know what? We really don't have time for that. Let's bust out the Tauros. Do we get to see the Ultra Wormhole in its entirety, or is it still too dark? You almost fell off the stairs, Tauros. Watch where you're going. That was your fault, not mine. So we are back up here. I'm just going to save it right now just to see if anything happens. I don't want to jump into the portal. I'm going to wait for the next episode. Let's just see. There's strange distortion in the air, but you don't seem to be able to traverse it now. Alright, so we do have to wait. So tonight, when I record at midnight, and you'll see it tomorrow, we're going to jump into that Ultra Wormhole, maybe, if it opens, and see what happens there. But there's still plenty more we can check out. There are, of course, like I say, I want to defend my title against the Pokemon League using teams of level 100 Pokemon. And, no, before I do that, the first mission is going to be to get this last Ultra Beast, so you'll see what happens in the next episode, but I'm going to see if I can get all of these Zygarde cells to get Perfect Form Zygarde as one of our backups to deal with the Ultra Beast here on Pony Island. I hope it's at a decent level when we assemble it, though, because if it's under-leveled, I don't know if it's really going to pull through in the fight. But we'll have to see what happens. Anyway, I want to say thanks for watching today's episode of Pokemon Moon. If you missed any episodes thus far, there's a link in the description to the entire playlist, of course. You can check that out and get caught up on all the adventures leading up to episode 78 right here. And if you want to check out some other videos I have done, you can check out the links in the outro to some other videos, plus a link to subscribe to the channel for daily Pokemon content. And I forgot to mention this, but if you enjoy the episode, feel free to throw a like down below and leave a comment letting me know what you thought of the episode and anything you know that I'm missing I haven't accomplished yet in the Alola region in the post-game, and just basically to get this as comprehensive of a playthrough as possible for you folks out there to watch. With all that, I guess we are done for the day. I want to say once again, thanks for watching today's episode. Professor Chaz is now signing off, and as always, I'll catch you next time.